Essentially, what we're gonna do is build off of that original like basketball scene that we had in the original video and kind of basically, man, just turn it into like a full-on music video, man. First of all, if this is your first time tuning into this channel, we go over like small-time music video productions. I'm just a guy running around with a camera. I'm not like some super professional guy that has all this film school, educational background, nothing like that. I'm literally just a guy that loves music and likes music video editing, and I have a camera. And so I just put all that together into this channel, man. So if you guys like content like this, make sure you subscribe to this channel and check out some of the other content we have on it as well. So basically what I'm going to do is just take you guys through as much of the ritualistic stuff that I do in terms of like setting up for some of these scenes and whatnot. Like I said, I am just a guy kind of by myself, so obviously you're not going to be able to see everything. But if you guys have any questions over anything you guys saw in this particular video, don't forget to leave a comment below. So just really quick, guys, a couple things that I typically bring with me on stuff or on music video stuff anyways that I bring with me are like, I always make sure I have audio. So yeah, all the audio is coming out of this H1, which is just connected with a Purple Panda lavalier mic. If you know, I'll leave all the stuff linked down below as well. They are affiliated and I'm not trying to make like $1 million from all that stuff. I'm literally just trying to just help you guys out by just quickly referencing all the stuff that I'm talking about. I also do have another iPhone as well, which I bring along with me and just kind of set up wherever I need to set it up just to get a good angle of me filming from behind the scenes since I am working by myself. Now, the reason why I like filming on the iPhone is because it's very convenient. It's very quick. I literally just hit record. I use Filmic Pro. I can just grab exposure real quick. Just take the yellow or the white circle or whatever. Make it red, exposure locked, everything's set. It's got super wide angle on it as well. If you guys know, the iPhone has got like two lenses on it. Some of them have three. I don't know like all the specifics on iPhones and Pro Max. All I know is that this one has two. It's got the wide and it's got like the regular one as well. So I do like the wide because I'm able to like, you know, you guys can see where I'm at and everything. I don't have to hold it like super far. I can hold it relatively close and you guys can see what's going on. Also as well, I like to keep everything as light and compact as possible. So right now I'm using this monopod. I used to use a tripod, but that's literally like takes up too much space and it's really cumbersome, really hard to bring along on any shoot and stay as mobile as possible. So I like this monopod, man. Pretty dope. To me personally, I used to have a Manfrotto one. This one's way better, man. Just go ahead and cop this one if you're looking for a good monopod. For my handheld stuff, I'm still on the Pocket 4K. I've got the small rig, kind of like wooden handles or whatever, allows me to hold it and keep it pretty much relatively steady throughout any handheld movement that I do. For this particular shoot that I'm shooting today, I'm gonna be primarily using the Super Tacomar 50mm. It's a vintage lens. I've done a couple other videos on them as well. I'll post them up here or wherever it pops up at. Still got the same monitor, man. This is pretty much the same setup I've worked with for like the past, I don't know, like the past year or so. And I haven't strayed away from it. So, I mean, I guess that kind of speaks volumes to this overall setup being, you know, non-cumbersome, as much of a minimalistic setup as possible. I really like it. Make my bank account, my son gave me extra scenery, extra scenery. To kind of stick with this whole mobile theme that I'm running with, I have this old tripod, the tripod that I was talking about earlier. I took the bag that it came with and I just pretty much stick like those really cheap Amazon tripods in them. So I have like four or five of them in here that I kind of set up these smaller lights that I'm going to talk about here in a minute. This bag is dope. Comes really handy. So if you guys have any like tripod bags that are just sitting around doing nothing, stick like, you know, really cheap tripods in them from Amazon. They're like $10 or $15. Coming clutch. Inside this bag right here, I literally just have all of my lights that I talked about earlier. These are all my Wii lights. Coming clutch, man. I've done a ton of videos on these lights. Gotta pick these up, man. They're like $40 or $50 RGB. They have all the effects. They last forever. I've got a ton of MPF batteries here that I use for some other lights that I have as well in the event that I do need other lights. The last thing I'll talk about, man, just so I don't bore you guys to death, is this 5:1 reflector, man. You got to have this. You never know when you want to like reflect light or kind of block light. or just kind of make light softer in the event that you don't have a lot of clouds to deal with, man, you've got to have one of these. This is pretty much like standard, man. Like, this is really cheap too. I think it's like 20, 25 bucks. You can pick this up easily, but easily a must have for anyone out there like doing music video content by yourself. I easily got a whole bunch of other stuff that I take along with me as well. But like I said, man, I don't want to bore you guys with all this stuff. If you guys have any questions concerning any of the stuff you saw here in this video, make sure you hit me up in the comments below. But as of right now, my boy Hun is here, man. We're gonna get started, man. I know y'all peeped out the GoPro that's on my chest. I always like to keep another, I guess, like supplementary type of footage when I do the behind the scenes stuff. Working by yourself, you don't have access to other people holding other cameras, so I highly recommend like at least wearing like a body cam or like a helm cam, or just having another GoPro set up to the side. And the reason why I say GoPro is because GoPro is just like the iPhone, man. It's just like, you know, any other mobile device where you can just literally just click record. You don't have to worry about like profile settings or anything like that. In my opinion, I don't think the behind the scenes content really needs to be like really like high quality necessarily, like shooting in RAW, shooting in S-Log and all this stuff. The fact that I use the iPhone and I use Filmic Pro gives me that ability to use like some type of log profile. But even if it didn't have log profile, I still would be using some type of mobile device as well. So just some I guess key points that I've learned along the way, man. Always carry a body cam, gotta have it. So can you just play it on your phone? This is the last scene. Look, this is how I gotta record myself. This is the last scene for Ball Different. I shot out here a couple times, but I haven't really captured like the particular part that we're gonna shoot. So basically the whole concept of this last portion is if you guys are familiar with that super rocky area going out towards the beach line. Obviously it's a really nice area. It's a really nice location. You know, we on the beach and whatever, but sometimes you still have some difficult things that you need to overcome. And so we're gonna capture the recording artist right here, you know, just walking over the rocks. You know, they slippery, they treacherous. You might fall through and might have some problems. But anyways, man, you know, we finna get some drone shots out here and capture some environmental shots as well. This works, right? Can you hear me? Yo. How about the volume? Can the volume turn up?
That's
15. Yeah, it's at 15, yo. Yeah, I'm just gonna be like running, and you just choose where you wanna run it.
Starts at a minute. I started at 30 seconds.
But the first part, I'm just gonna get you walking out, but it's all gotta be on one flight. So I'm not gonna land there, and I'm just gonna go straight into it. Yeah. People always, bro, you don't know how many times, like, I've been out filming, doing whatever, doing my thing, and people are like laughing and pointing at this. Then when the bro, it's a completely different story. It's gonna be kind of far away. Hold on, cause I gotta check out something. You may not be able to perform on the edge because there's people fishing right there. So we might just have to switch it up to a handheld. Obviously, there may be some other projects that require some bigger lights. So, you know, I may tend to bring out the Godox SL or like the Quasar Science tube lights. For most of my projects, I tend to live in kind of like that natural lighting space, I guess, if you want to call it. And in the event that I do need like extra light, obviously, I will bring those lights as needed. If you got any value out of this video, man, don't hesitate to hit that like button. It helps the channel out tremendously. Appreciate all the support. If you like content like this, man, this channel pretty much covers like solo filmmaking stuff, particularly dealing with music videos. So if that's something that you're interested in, make sure you check out some of the other content on this channel as well, man. But that's all for this video right now, man. I'll see y'all in the next one. Extra read about it. I'm today's trying to tap it. I put commas over bullshit. Yeah, I put that on mamas. They trying to black on my blessings. They thought I lost a stepping. I bet on me and my team. ISO is what I'm repping. Put on for the whole city. Yeah, I got them rocking with me. I bet on me and my team. ISO is what I'm repping. Sending emojis. I'm blowing a pack of that OG. Don't be acting like you know me. And if you did, that's the old me. Winter time, rock a cold fleece. Pocket fat, that's obese. Only talking money if it's increased. She give me brain, girl, no teeth. I touch down, bust down. She busted open for a real nigga. Stay Tommy'd up, trying to build it up, trying to count it up. Hell figures. Don't be chilling. Don't forget to check out my reframing template. It allows you to
to be able to keyframe better, reframe your shots, and post a whole lot better. You can check that out in the description below. Especially now, if you're shooting in 4K or 6K, if you have the Pocket 6K, or any K for that matter, higher than 1080 if you're editing in a 1080 timeline. We all know how that affords you the option to be able to punch in to simulate another camera angle. Now, obviously, if you're anything like me and you use your rule of thirds that's built into your camera while you're recording footage, that's all fine and dandy, but when it comes to actually reframing or keyframing in post, or making sure graphics are centered, or whatever the case may be, when it comes to being able to make sure things in the frame are where they need to be, this reframing template is all you need. All you do is click and drag this PNG over your video file, and now you're able to go ahead and reframe your shot exactly the way you want it. Anyways, guys, that's all for this video. I appreciate y'all checking this out, and I hope to see you in one of my next ones. Peace. 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 Peace.